You don't need any of that.
I don't want none.
Right. Game face is on it. He's done it again. He's going for the record.
I don't believe it.
Brock is back.
Again. You might as well come back full time at this, right?
Yeah. I think he's missed like two Raws this year.
Bloody hell. That's impressive considering we're what, 3 months into the year.
Mm.
And of course, he had this advocate with him. I'm just an advocate.
Oh. Yeah, it's a good promo from Paul. I was waiting for it because he was running down McIntyre. Running him down.
Uh-oh.
So he only eliminated Brock because of that low blow at the Royal Rumble.
That damn Ricochet.
Didn't he call him a bitch at one point as well?
Possibly.
Well, this brought out a very angry man.
Yeah. They sort of squared out one another. Brock laughed. Went to leave the ring. And then he tried a sneak attack, but he got a claymore kick for his troubles.
And the crowd let him have it.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, it's funny when he got kicked and the crowd were chanting, "You deserve it." Well, no, you weren't done yet because he went off the ramp and then, boom, he got kicked again.
Where?
You weren't done.
Then Brock, not too discreetly, pick up the bells.
Oh, boy.
I gotta say this. He doesn't have said enough. I love Brock. We need more Brock in our lives.
When he's in the mood.
You put him against a guy who he genuinely enjoys working with. The bloke's great. He's pure gold.
Well, what about if you put him against a guy that he don't want to work with?
Sucks to be the guy that he doesn't want to work with.
The match kind of gets a bit... It stinks. Well, the opening shot's been fired.
Yeah.
How will Lesnar respond?
Find out. Maybe next week.
Next week. I'm calling it. He's going to turn up again.
Yeah, because I don't think either of them have got a match this Sunday at Elimination Chamber.
No. No title. The Universal title's not on the line. WWE title's not on the line.
Why do they need to put the Universal title on the line? They got defended at the Dirty Saudi Show.
No one cares about the Dirty Saudi Show. It's irrelevant.
Except for the Saudis.
Except for Vince. Get in, pal.
Oh, man. We got a title match next.
Oh, kicking off the show with a title match.
We've got Murphy and Rollins.
Murph the Smurf.
Yes, that's becoming their new tag team name.
No, that's what the Street Profits call Murphy.
Murph the Smurf.
Murph the Smurf.
And they're defending their Raw tag titles against Street Profits.
And it's got to be said, my God, the crowd love the Street Profits.
They're great.
You see how many cups were in the crowd? I'm not sure if they were giving them out or they were just selling them, but they were everywhere.
Mm. Oof. This was good.
Yeah, I mean, for a match that had Murphy in it, I didn't mind. I mean, you were waiting for the interference, though, because they had AOP parked on the ramp.
Mm.
They weren't going backstage. So I was like, right, yeah, they're going to come down at some point.
Were the Viking Raiders going to get involved?
No, I didn't see them.
Mm.
Didn't see them. Maybe they were on promotional duty somewhere.
Maybe.
Well, no, the AOP did get involved, and it ended up costing them.
Oh, dear.
Because they were arguing with the ref. The ref was distracted.
Oh.
And a mysterious individual snuck up behind Seth.
Wouldn't be Kevin Owens, would it?
It would.
Oh.
And he put some stank on him.
What?
Austin will be proud of that one.
But more importantly, did Rollins keep the glove on?
No, I don't think he did.
The heel glove.
The heel glove.
Yeah, he means business now that he's got the one glove on.
Uh-oh. All
right. And we've got new tag team champions.
Yes, after a frog splash.
From Montez Ford.
Mm. They finally did it. They won the tag titles. Maybe now we can get back to actual tag team wrestling again.
Hey.
They're bringing the swag.
Did they take a celebratory sip from the cup?
Quite a few. Because they went into the crowd and the crowd would just hand them drinks.
Mm. Oh, okay.
And so they were sipping from everyone's cup.
Oh, it's not very hygienic.
Which in this day and age isn't wise. You don't know who's drinking out of what. It's not like we got an epidemic going on or anything.
Not a good start for the Monday Night Messiah. But apparently they're going to be getting a rematch.
They are. Apparently it's this Sunday. I don't know.
Oh boy. Here's where it starts to go downhill drastically. So, apparently Vince is done with Ricochet for the foreseeable future.
That's the reports we're hearing.
Doesn't care for him.
Because if it wasn't bad enough that Brock beat him in a minute and a half, which I found a bit strange. So I was like, you know, Brock tends to like working with small guys.
Mm-hmm.
Not like they had to rush the show or anything.
No.
So then you're thinking, okay, now he's fighting for the 24/7 title against Riddick Moss.
Mm.
Who's never had a one-on-one match on TV.
Nope.
At one point in this match, the crowd were chanting, "Who are you?" to Riddick Moss.
Well, that guy, who nobody's got a clue who he is, beat Ricochet clean.
Oh, God.
What are you playing at, Vince?
And not only that, he beat him with a neck break.
Oh, really?
Which, like, doesn't beat anyone, ever.
Have a word, Vince.
Losing the plot.
Yeah.
Someone, please retire this man.
Ricochet's a genuine main event contender. And they're pulling crap like this on him. You know what? If this is the crap that Vince is going to be pulling, send Ricochet back to NXT.
They should. Triple H should have him back in a heartbeat.
Let him do some good with him.
Right, so now we were supposed to have the much anticipated match between AJ Styles and Aleister Black.
Didn't quite go that way, did
it? No. Apparently Black didn't read the contract.
Has he got to earn his match against AJ?
Yeah, he wants to fight AJ. He's got to fight Carl Anderson first.
Abs Anderson.
Yeah. Didn't go on for very long.
Did it finish with a mass?
Oh, Black. Yes. Oh, ow. I think Anderson might be picking up his teeth from the front row.
Bloody hell.
I saw something fly out. It might have been spit.
Yeah.
But now, again, he didn't read the contract. Because now he has to fight Luke Gallows.
Big LG.
Where do we get these nicknames from? We got Abs Anderson. We got Big LG.
And Uncle Al.
Uncle Alan. Oh, man. What the frick, man? Neither of you guys are Stone Cold.
What?
No, from what I remember, Gallows got disqualified.
He did. Can't remember what for now.
I think they ran in the ring, AJ and Anderson ran in the ring. When Black was about to win.
Yeah.
So we did finally get the match we were promised.
We did. AJ and Black.
Well, it wasn't really much of a match.
Uncle Alan got the job done with. Phenomenal forearm.
And to make matters even worse, rubbing it in. He did the Undertaker pin.
Oh, no.
With the crossed arms. He didn't do the tongue, which I was disappointed.
I think he sort of did at one point, but...
But what does it mean?
It means the Undertaker's turn up at some point and challenging Uncle Alan to a match.
But why? He already beat him.
Well, they'll probably play along with some BS rally. You know, it was a gauntlet match.
All right,
didn't count.
He didn't even have to take his coat off. Okay.
Well, next we got a rivalry match.
Yes, the implosion of the Riot Squad.
Mm. So we got Liv Morgan.
Yay.
Versus Ruby Riott.
Ugh.
Liv. Every damn time. And Sarah Logan was a special guest referee.
But she can actually wrestle. Why not do a triple threat? They're all in the Elimination Chamber.
Your guess is as good as mine. What the fuck, man?
Yeah. Oh, where do you even start with this one? This was crap. Pure crap.
Yeah.
It's like Ruby Riott is just ugh.
Talk about that wrestling match. Damn it.
Okay.
You're gonna get us in more trouble.
Okay. It was crap. It sucked. I don't understand the story behind it. Ruby Riott accidentally hit Sarah Logan with like a shoulder tackle.
Okay.
And then when Liv Morgan did the roll up, Sarah Logan fast counted her.
The fast count.
Yeah. God. 1, 2, 3, over. Ring the bell.
God damn.
And then Sarah Logan beat up Liv Morgan as well.
Huh.
Okay. Proving that she was the decent one in the Riot Squad.
Okay. So I'm guessing then we're sort of done with the whole Liv Morgan, Lana, Warren, Bob and Rusev storyline.
Yep, I think it's been swept under the carpet.
For good reasons.
So that was the end of that match. Ugh, send them back to the back. Ugh. Get right off of my TV.
For Christ's sake. Moving on. To something even more uglier.
Really? Can you get uglier?
Big Red.
Oh.
Rick Rowan.
Oh no. Rick Rowan. Right.
So, yeah. He was backstage. No Way Jose came along. He was like, hey man, I want to see what's in the cage. So Rowan turned around and said, oh, you're the first person to ask nicely. So I'll show you.
So after 4 months of wondering, well, okay, some people have been wondering, not many. A couple of people have been wondering. What's the big reveal? What is in the cage?
It was a robotic spider. Toys R Us.
Yeah. Probably from Smith's now. Do they still have Toys R Us over in America?
I think they are going back reopening over there.
No, it was a very poorly, very, very not real spider.
But no way Jose and the conga line ran away in fear.
Yeah, anyway. Even though it blatantly looked fake.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, my mum called it out as fake. And that tells you all you need to know.
Yeah. So moving on. What are some more women's action? So this was originally going to be Shayna Baszler versus Asuka.
What happened?
I don't know, but
oh yeah, she said she had a wrist injury.
Oh, come on.
She came out when she had a cast on her wrist.
Oh, for Christ. Yeah, so Kairi Sane took her spot. I am paying off a lot of attention to this match, but apparently it wasn't great.
No, it wasn't.
Apparently Vince was flipping off backstage about it.
He should have been. It wasn't a good match at all. I'm not sure. Maybe sometimes you get wrestlers who just don't click with each other.
Yeah.
This was it. I mean, they were messing moves up. The opening promo. Oh, God. We know these two can speak English. Why do they have them ramble incoherently in Japanese?
Are you sure they can speak the English?
I'm sure they can. Well, no, eventually, and you know, I wasn't really paying a tremendous amount of attention to it. Baszler won with the that submission move she does. There's so many clutches and locks. It's hard to keep track of them all.
Kirifuda clutch.
Yeah. Well, there's so many of them. It's hard to remember them all.
The camel clutch.
And then Becky Lynch came out at some point.
Right.
They got into a bit of a fight, and I think Baszler ran through the crowd.
Okay. So next, we've got the long-anticipated return. One of Sam's favourite people.
Oh, no.
It's the return of Andrade. It's Andrade and Angel Garza facing off against Ole Riri and Humberto Carrillo.
And in case you weren't aware, Angel Garza is supposed to be a heel.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, he is still kissing people in the crowd, taunting the ladies.
Wasn't there a moment in the match where Carrillo chucked Andrade into the ropes and he did like the catching the ropes thing and hanging there? And then, like, Garza dived underneath him.
Yeah.
And then I think Carrillo went to grab him and, like, pulled his pants off or something.
Yeah, I don't know. I wasn't paying attention to this one. I just didn't care. I don't care for any of the people in this match.
I like Carrillo.
He's alright.
Andrade's alright, and I don't like what they're doing with Garza at the minute, personally.
No, it's absolutely the wrong thing to do with him. But I do believe Carrillo picked up the win in this one.
Yeah. Carrillo pinned Andrade after he got hit with a 619, and then Ray took out Garza, and Carrillo picked up the pin with that swooping moonsault.
Oh yeah, yeah, the really good moonsault.
Yeah. So yeah, Carrillo finally got one up.
Do you know what that means? Now that he's pinned the champion,
does that mean he gets a title shot?
It does automatically because that's how it works.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You pin the champion, you get a title shot. That's how it works. Right, now the main segment / thing of the evening.
Yeah, so Beth Phoenix was going to be on Raw to give us an update on Edge.
Yeah. And it never happened.
Oh, Christ. Anyway, yes, Orton came out early on, interrupted her.
Yeah. So we didn't end up getting the update on Edge.
Did Orton again try to give some BS explanation?
Yes. Yes, he did. I mean, a lot of people were saying that a lot of people liked this promo from him. It was like, oh, yeah, he looked up to Edge back in the day. And Edge was one of the first people he met when he started in the company.
Apart from Mark Jindrak.
Yeah, well, we don't talk about Mark Jindrak.
Ask Triple H what he thinks of him.
Well, no, he did it because he wanted Edge's children to have a dad.
What?
Because if he's not wrestling, he's at home.
Oh, okay.
So he was really doing it for Beth, and he was doing it for the kids.
Okay. Different, I suppose.
And he's doing it because he loved Edge like a bruv.
Yes, because smashing his head between two chairs is a true sign of brotherly love.
Yeah.
So in the end, Orton got a big old round the face. And then, come on, man. You know what's coming next.
See, the crowd were even chanting it. I was like, don't chant it. Why are you chanting someone to RKO a woman?
Oh, no.
I despair with people sometimes.
Bloodthirsty animals. You people are ruthless.
And I tell you, as soon as this happened, I was like, he's going to RKO her at some point.
Well, it won't shock you to know. He did drop her with an RKO.
So let me get this straight. Nearly a decade after he RKO'd Steph in the rivalry with Triple H.
Yeah.
Now he's RKO'd someone else's wife.
Yeah, pretty much.
Here's an idea. Don't let your wife near Randy Orton. He RKO's them.
Wow. Excellent analysis there from Sam.
They've done it before.
Just leave him alone.
And we still didn't get the update on Edge.
No. So it makes me wonder, are we going to see Edge next week? Is he going to come and spear Randall? Spear him into next week.
I don't want to know he's there.
No.
Leave it a surprise.
Yep.
We know he's going to come back. We know he's going to spear him.
We know he's going to fight him at Mania.
Well. Just give me a little bit of a surprise.
Amongst the other 15 rumoured matches for Mania.
Oh my god, it can't be that many.
Apparently we're getting an all Mexico fight for the US title.
I don't want to watch that match. And that's all we're going to do for this edition, because we've been waffling on for way too long.
Rambling on incoherently.
So that's going to do it. From your hosts, the master of the brain damage,
Martin,
and the one and only Sam H, we will see you again for the next one.
Yeah.